What if I told you there was one supplement that has a similar mechanism of action as Ozempic, but actually outperforms it?
Welcome to the Joe Cohen Show. Join me as I share my experience with biohacking and invite top health experts to explore the latest technology, supplements, research, and resources for optimizing your body and brain.
It has no side effects and is one of the healthiest things you can do. It's good for the cardiovascular system. It can prevent cancer and many other chronic diseases. It modulates the immune system. It can counteract generations of negative epigenetic changes. This supplement is called resistant starch. Ozempic is a very popular drug that is taking Hollywood by storm. It makes you feel fuller for longer. It does this by increasing a certain protein called GLP-1. Now, resistant starch itself, which is a fiber, also increases GLP-1. In addition, when it turns into butyrate, that butyrate itself also increases GLP-1. So there's two different ways by which resistant starch increases GLP-1. In fact, resistant starch might even be better because it increases GLP-1 in a continuous basis, whereas Ozempic is more short-term. There was a recent study done that was published in Nature showed that people taking this resistant starch, it's a specific type of resistant starch, lost 2.8 kilograms or 6.2 pounds. They took this for 8 weeks. Normally, in the studies of Ozempic, they only found much more significant effects in 12 weeks. So this resistant starch, which is a maize-resistant starch, it's not the crap that you get from potato starch or raw banana flour. It's this maize-derived resistant starch. What they found was that people were lost 2.8 kilograms or 6.2 pounds in 8 weeks. Rather, Ozempic had similar weight loss, but in 12 weeks or 3 months. In addition, Ozempic has a very significant side effect. While it causes weight loss, when you actually dive into the data, it causes some fat loss, but it also causes muscle loss. Now, with resistant starch, the study didn't measure this directly, but there's other studies showing that butyrate can increase muscle growth. And from my personal experience, what I found is that when I take high levels of resistant starch, not only do I lose weight, my muscles are also getting bigger. So my six-pack shows more. My chest shows more. It just feels like I am stronger. Resistant starch also has another property that Ozempic doesn't have. First of all, there's other mechanisms by which it causes weight loss that Ozempic does not have. In addition, it does things like increase BDNF. So BDNF is this neurotrophic factor for the brain. It's like quick sprout for the brain. And butyrate and resistant starch is one of the easiest ways to increase BDNF. What is the difference between resistant starch and butyrate and how do they relate to one another? So resistant starch is the fiber that you consume. And when this fiber goes into your colon, everyone has bacteria to break down this fiber on some level or another. Some people might have more bacteria to convert it into resistant starch and some people might have less. But almost everybody has some bacteria to convert resistant starch into butyrate. This butyrate is not only really good for your large intestine and prevents things like ulcerative colitis, IBD, cancer, so bowel cancer, but the butyrate can also pass the gut barrier and get into the brain barrier. So it could also pass through the brain barrier. And butyrate is an energy molecule that can be very good for the brain. Butyrate is an amazing molecule for the brain. So it helps with mood, it helps with cognitive function. And one of the interesting things about butyrate is it's one of the few molecules that can cause broad epigenetic changes. So this is known as an HDAC inhibitor. And we don't need to go into the details, but this set of molecules is being studied for anti-cancer, cardiovascular disease, autoimmunity, and the reason it does is because it reprograms the immune system almost. This is something that isn't just like you take it and it changes one protein. It's actually changing the epigenetics. It's a broad spectrum histone deacetylase inhibitor. There's nothing else that I'm aware of that is a broad spectrum HDAC inhibitor that can cause all these epigenetic changes to the cell. So for example, when it comes to the gut, you can increase T regulatory cells when you increase butyrate. These T regulatory cells make you tolerant to various foods and they reduce food sensitivities. Butyrate is one of the best things, that and niacin, I would say, but it's been one of the best things for me to reverse my food sensitivities. Now, butyrate can both stimulate the immune system, but also inhibit it. It's a modulator. It's not something that you could say is broad immunostimulatory or broad immunosuppressed. It's one of those things that it changes the programming of the cells. It sounds a little woo, but it really is one of the few things that is causing broad epigenetic changes through this HDAC inhibition. Now, you could take resistant starch or you could supplement with butyrate. The problem with butyrate is it tastes very bad. It has a certain kind of pungent smell that is not very pleasant. It can cause nausea. The resistant starch is the raw material that your body then knows how to create butyrate from. And it's actually much more efficient to just give your body the raw material and for your body, your microbiome, to create this butyrate. It basically turns into a butyrate factory, essentially. So you have a bunch of different types of bacteria. It's not just one bacteria. There's many dozens of bacteria that can convert resistant starch into butyrate. And these bacteria basically act as an assembly line. They take this raw material and they produce the butyrate in response. Now, the amount of butyrate you can get this way is significantly more than taking pills. And the way that it is distributed is also better because you're getting a steady stream of butyrate over time when you get it from resistant starch, rather because it takes time for the microbes to turn this in. They're basically, you have a certain amount of microbes and they're consuming these things. So there is a rate limiting factor in how fast you can convert the butyrate. And so this conversion goes on, in my experience, for about 8 hours. Whereas if you take a butyrate pill, it's got a very short half-life, and then the effect is gone after 45 minutes or an hour. Whereas this butyrate factory that you're producing with the resistant starch, if you take resistant starch twice a day, it can create basically the whole day you're creating some butyrate and reprogram your cells so that, number one, you are tolerant to outside food. So it's very good, I found, for food sensitivities, for allergies, for reducing inflammation, especially gut type of inflammation, but I found inflammation all over the place. It's very good for cognitive function. So it's a molecule that functions like ATP and lactate for the brain. It's this energy-related molecule that the brain could consume. So just like some people do well on ketones, people can do very well on butyrate. Ketones and butyrate are similar type molecules, and they both can be used by the brain for energy. So I find it's very good. It has all the benefits pretty much of ketosis without the negatives of ketosis. So it gives you that brain energy throughout the day. It gives you that wakefulness promoting factor. It gives you the BDNF. It gives you a much better mood because butyrate also increases serotonin. And the resistant starch and butyrate also decrease hunger. So you're less hungry, but it also increases muscle mass. So the butyrate can actually increase muscle mass on its own. So when we're looking at the benefits of butyrate, basically in the self-decode software, you could fill in your symptoms, conditions, and goals, and you could also upload lab markers and fill out a bunch of questionnaires and see how this interacts with a bunch of different information. So what we see in the program is that historically, I had gut inflammation, and butyrate is very good for that. So it shows that it's helping me prevent, it's preventing me from having gut inflammation. If you have gut inflammation, it can reduce it. So another goal that it can help with is muscle growth. I'm always trying to increase my muscles. And the evidence there is not very great, but you could click on it and see the studies. But I do think that it helps on some degree or another. And now here you could see some of the benefits. I have the filter here, include items without clinical trials. If we want to only include items with clinical trials, it will limit it more. So with clinical trials, it helps with diarrhea, which makes sense because it's killing also the bad microbes in the large intestine. So not only does it increase good microbes, it reduces bad microbes because these good microbes compete with the other ones. And it also changes the pH of the large intestine, makes it more acidic, which makes it harder for certain microbes to grow. Next is it helps with high blood sugar. Not only does resistant starch help with high blood sugar, but butyrate itself helps with irritable bowel, overweight. So again, this is just butyrate on its own, not even resistant starch, gut inflammation, high blood pressure, and can help with fasting glucose as well. Now, we're going to look at resistant starch. Resistant starch comes up as number 63 on as a whole for all recommendations in total. And you could see things that it helps with: mood, gut inflammation, anxiety. These are symptoms and conditions that I've had in the past, not anymore. Goals, mood, and stamina. And you see I have a genetic predisposition for low mood. And then similar, the resistant starch is going to help with diarrhea. It could also help with endurance, reduce inflammation, insulin resistance. So that's also one of the main benefits of resistant starch, is it could help with insulin resistance. It'll reduce fasting glucose, HbA1c. It'll help reduce cholesterol levels, constipation, high blood sugar, kidney health. So resistant starch in particular is very good for kidney health. It's that fiber helps detox from certain kidney toxins that would otherwise, it's called these indoxal sulfates and other kidney toxins that would otherwise get too high. It could also help detox against ammonia, gut inflammation, overweight, metabolic syndrome, and tendency to overeat. I've noticed benefits in all these aspects from taking resistant starch. So it does make you feel more full. And so you get all these benefits from the resistant starch, which some of it is from the fiber itself. For example, if you take in the fiber, it makes GLP-1 go up even regardless of the butyrate, because it just makes you feel more full. That is from the GLP-1 hormone. And then the butyrate has those additional effects as well. And you could see these blood markers is fasting glucose, hemoglobin A1C. These are not in the optimal range the last time I took it. And then it's also helping with things that were not in the optimal range in the past, but now are. So things like hsCRP, cholesterol, LDL cholesterol, and things like that. Resistant starch has been one of the biggest game changers that I've been doing. I've been taking it for 11 years. The thing to note about resistant starch is you have to take the right kind. So most of the kinds that are sold on the market are potato starch or green banana starch. And the problem with those types of resistant starch is that they have a lot of lectins. So I got a lot of brain fog from these types of resistant starch, whereas the Joe's resistant starch or a maize-derived resistant starch, the way it's processed, it takes out the lectins. It's also GMO-free, and so there's no issues with GMO. But, and basically, even when I was most sensitive to anything, basically I was eating a diet, I couldn't even eat vegetables at a certain point. I was just eating meat, and I was on a carnivore diet, and this is 11 years ago before carnivore ever existed. And I was only able to eat meat basically without getting a reaction. And so I needed some carbs, and the only carb that I was not reacting to was resistant starch. So that was the one thing that really, people are concerned sometimes about corn, but this is the one starch I couldn't eat anything. I couldn't eat corn. I couldn't eat anything. They process it in a way that gets rid of any of these lectins or negative things. And since it's GMO free, you don't get the glyphosate and all the other bad things. I'm one of the few people I know that basically I've got a very bulging six pack and very low body fat without even trying. I don't get hungry. One of the keys of this success, I believe, is, and based on the research, is that I've been taking this resistant starch for the past 12 years. And if you look at a genetic similarity, which is my brother, he has a very similar build. He's got a very big stomach. He's got a lot of fat around his belly. And so I really think that one of the things that is a differentiator for me is this resistant starch. So in terms of what you take, I highly recommend, the only one I highly recommend is Joe's resistant starch. And in terms of the dosing, the clinical trial that found 6.2 pounds in 8 weeks, they used 90 grams of Joe's resistant starch a day. Now, for me, I'm more on a maintenance type of protocol, so I take 45 grams a day. But if you're someone who wants to lose more weight, I would recommend following the protocol of the study. So that would be 90 grams a day of Joe's resistant starch. And you can expect 6.2 pounds to be lost in 8 weeks. This is according to a study published in Nature in 2024. And this is also on the back of previous studies that found effects on weight loss and blood glucose, insulin sensitivity, and then also on my own personal experience of people, other people that I've seen, even in the company, people, a bunch of people started taking it and found weight loss benefits to it. This is definitely one of my top three supplements ever. If I had to be on an island somewhere and I could just take a few supplements, resistant starch would be one of them. And the reason is because butyrate is just one of those things that it just reprograms the body in a way that nothing else does. It really does. For food sensitivities, it's like almost nothing really works like butyrate. I would say nothing is equivalent to how butyrate works, except for niacin. But besides niacin, and I would say they're comparable, by the way. They both work on a specific receptor, actually, that counteracts food sensitivities. That's the, I believe it's called the HCA2 receptor, or the GPR109A receptor. It's very hard to remember these specific names, but basically, it's definitely a game changer, and it could be bought on Amazon. I think it's very clear that, as a disclaimer, that this is my company, but the reason why I'm very passionate about this, I only sell two supplements. This is one of them. And so it's not like I have a supplement company here. It's more like this one supplement I'm really passionate about, and I think everybody should take it. You could say, oh, you got certain genetics here. The question is what dosage you're taking, then genetics can come into factor. But everybody should be getting resistant starch. Maybe you're taking 10 grams a day. Maybe you want to take 90 or even 100, right? That is a factor of what are your goals, what are your genetics. For me, I personally find 45 grams to be good. But this could be lower or higher based on a bunch of factors. 67% of listeners aren't subscribed to the show, so please don't forget to show your support by hitting the subscribe button now. You'll not only be supporting the show, but also investing in yourself and your health journey, all while helping to keep us ad-free.